snow and celebrating the 67th birthday of this venue. Let's do it quickly. How about another happy birthday? One, two, three, four.
Happy birthday.
Last 3 nights, we talked a little bit about history of the shoe and why we've done these multiple nights since the 50th anniversary. It goes back to the history of this venue back from 1947 to 1980 with the owner doing these long week musical 4 to 7 night stands. We've talked a little bit about the passion of following your favorite bands through North America and the world, whoever they may be. And other stuff. And by the way, tonight in the audience, we have some people that have been here for our 4 shows. Put up your hands, you've been here for all 4 shows. Very quickly, we have a gentleman here that made a t-shirt just today. Please get up on the stage very quickly. Last night, we had some problems with confetti. And it says, the whole city almost killed me with confetti. People in here have come from London, England, or U.S., like St. Louis and Chicago. We have a fanatical fan who's in the front row, who's been in the front row all 4 days. This is Brendan. Tonight, this is his 70th Hold Steady show. And on behalf of the owners of the Horseshoe, you've got him a little gift. Now, before the band kills me, a very short story I wanted to tell about us trying to program the last 17 years during this particular time to try and get a band to come up and do a full week or 4 days of shows. Back 7 years ago, during the Horseshoe Tavern 60th birthday, I wanted to bring back Stompin Tom Connors to this venue. Craig and I were talking a little earlier. He wanted to know a little bit more about Stompin Tom, and I told him about it. He said to me, "Gave you permission to tell this quick story. Are you ready?" Stompin Tom holds the record for doing 25 consecutive nights right here on this stage. So 7 years ago on the 60th anniversary, I wanted Stompin Tom to do what these guys are doing, a night of 4, Wednesday to Saturday, 4 shows. And I figured, you know, I don't know if you know much about Stompin Tom, but you know, he just plays with him and the guitar and the horn, right? But I wanted to have Blue Rodeo be his backing band. So I went to Jim Cuddy about a year before, and I said, "Jim, Greg, what do you think of this crazy idea?" It's amazing. We love it. We're in. We'll get hold of Stompin Tom. So Jim calls me a couple months later and says, "JC, I don't know how to get a hold of Stompin Tom." He says, "I know how to get a hold of Stompin Tom. He lives like 75 kilometers north of Toronto. He doesn't have a phone or anything. Just need to put 3 cases of Canadian beer, warm, not cold, in the car, and drive up there, and he'll spend hours with you talking." So Jim does this, goes up by himself. Stompin Tom, "Oh, Jim Cuddy from Blue Rodeo, great." Tells him the whole spiel. Jeff Cohen of the Horseshoe Tavern wants you to come and play 4 nights to celebrate the 60th anniversary. Tom says, "I'm in, let's do it. It's done." Okay? Yeah. 2 months later, Jim phones me up and says, "The gig is off." And I go, "What's wrong?" Well, Tom says, you know, he's a chain smoker. He smokes like every 2 seconds, and he knows he can't smoke in the Horseshoe, so he said, "I said, you know what? Tom can smoke. Pay the fine and don't give a sprat's ass. Tell David Miller, the mayor, or whatever, to fuck off." So everything's good. Gig's back on. A month later, Jim calls me up again and says, "JC, no, it can't do it. What's wrong?" Well, Tom says, "It's okay that you're allowing him to smoke, but if he can smoke, then the whole audience needs to be able to smoke." And so I go, "Fine, the whole audience can smoke. I'll pay all the fines. Anything to get Stompin Tom in here one more time." The gig is on. I'm about to put it on Ticketfly, and Jim calls me and says, "Forget it, it's over." I said, "What now? Everybody can smoke or whatever." Well, I called him up to ask what 20 songs we're going to do, or, you know, our catalog of 40 songs over the 4 nights, and Tom says, "Oh, no, I don't pick the songs. You have to learn every one of my songs, all 600 of them, and then on the stage, I just call them before we play." Yes. I said, "Well, Jim, can you do that?" He goes, "I can, but Greg cannot learn that very well." So the gig was off. We never got Stompin Tom to play here one more time. I mean, Blue Rodeo came and did the nights and everything like that. And it was followed by Joel Plaskett, 5040, Maria Statics, and the Weaker Thans, and all those Constantines, and Lois Low, all those great bands. But it's okay. It's okay. At least on the 60th anniversary that night, Stompin Tom actually sent someone from his place, 75 kilometers up north in Ontario, and he signed something to me personally in the Horseshoe saying, "Dear Jeff Cohen in the Horseshoe Tavern, I couldn't make it to the 60th, but this is my favorite rock and roll club in the world." Yeah. It sits above the desk in my office. Without much further ado, can you please welcome the final night of what has been a legendary stand in a legendary venue, the whole stadium!
Been here with us four nights. So you guys know there's been kind of a theme to each night, right?
Yeah! I'm staying positive.
The theme of tonight is we're gonna do whatever the fuck we want. And we aren't gonna worry about it. I'm gonna drink a bunch of alcohol and we're gonna have a good time. Go ahead and tell me we fucking love you.